An attempt to protect the rights of religious groups that are threatened by a new federal health policy fails by a thin margin in the U.S. Senate. This is the CitizenLink Report. I'm Carrie Gordon-Earle with CitizenLink federal issues analyst Ashley Horn. Hi, Ashley.
Hi, Carrie.
Thanks for being here today. The topic is this new federal mandate in the healthcare law that requires all employers, even religious ones, to have to provide their employees with health insurance that covers possible abortion-causing drugs, contraception, sterilizations. There's no religious exemption really to speak to here. And contrary to what folks may be hearing, this is really about religious freedom. This is really about a power grab of the government to come in and tell these ministries, organizations, universities, and so forth that they have to provide this coverage to their employees. Now, something has happened with this that was exciting. There was a key vote in the U.S. Senate to provide some clear exemptions for these groups, profit and nonprofit alike. Mm-hmm. What happened with that vote, and what was that vote about?
You know, in response to the national outcry over this, like you said, people have just been going nuts. Like, what's going on? Why would you force groups, religious groups or employers, or even people who just have a moral objection to possibly abortifacient contraception, to go ahead and provide that for employees? There's just no reason to do that. And like you said, the exemption for religious groups is way too small. It does not cover schools, universities, other nonprofits. And so what Senator Roy Blunt did and Congressman Jeff Fortenberry in the House, they said, you know what, we're going to get together, we're going to draft a bill that will hopefully protect these employers where the government is not looking to protect them at all. And the vote did fail by a slim margin, but it was still more of a symbolic vote. Look, we want to stand up and say, this is not right. You cannot force employers against their religious beliefs, against their moral objections, to do things that are wrong or that they perceive to be wrong.
And again, this is for nonprofit. You mentioned universities, colleges, soup kitchens, homeless shelters, but it's also for profits. If you listen to a Christian radio station, Christian TV station, you go to a bookstore, all of these folks would be compelled under this to violate their religious tenets, their religious faith, by offering their employees possible abortion-causing drugs. So now that it's not going anywhere at the moment in the Senate, what is the sentiment in the House? I would think that this would be an opportunity for the more conservative House to really take a lead on this.
They should, and I expect that they will. As I said before, Congressman Jeff Fortenberry has taken the lead in the House. We see leadership moving in that direction, and so I would expect to see a vote on this very soon.
Well, it's been interesting to watch because there have been a number of organizations, universities and others, that have filed suit. And then there is now another lawsuit that's been filed by the state attorneys general in seven states. And this suit alleges that these new federal rules violate the First Amendment rights of these religious groups by forcing them to offer this coverage. Lawsuits are unpredictable, but what is the chance that one of these lawsuits could get resolved to prevent this from going into effect? Because the effect date is 2013. It's right around the corner.
That's right. The mandate, the government said, we'll give you an extra year before you have to comply with this mandate or violate your religious beliefs or your moral convictions. And so it's possible that we could see one of these cases come about or be resolved before that deadline comes into play. There are lots of lawsuits around the federal health care mandate, so we'll just have to wait and see.
And we will keep an eye on this, and we do want to encourage people to keep praying about this as well. To contact us here at CitizenLink to let us know your thoughts, you can always write to us and let us know what you're thinking at mail@citizenlink.com. That's mail@citizenlink.com, and we do read your emails. We do enjoy hearing from you. Please do continue praying about religious freedom and liberty in our country. This is a legacy we want for our generation and for the next. So this is worth investing your prayer and your energy in this direction. And remember, stand tall and be heard.